the propeller shaft, it is also called the drive shaft. The propeller shaft, you can see in the figure, the propeller shaft is a driving shaft which connects the transmission main shaft. Transmission main shaft, in fact, the shaft which is connecting to the gearbox. The propeller shaft is a driving shaft which connects the transmission main shaft to the differential of the rear axle. Rear axle means this is the component which connects the two wheels of the vehicle. Okay, rear vehicle, rear wheels. And the propeller shaft transmits the power from gearbox to the rear axle with the help of universal joints. You can see left and right. I will bring the cursor here. This is one universal shaft. This is another universal shaft. Propeller shaft transmits the power from the gearbox to the rear axle with the help of universal joints. The main function of propeller shaft, if you look into what exactly it performs, what is its major function? The main function of propeller shaft is to connect two mechanical elements or component. That is, one component is called the driving element and another component is called driven element. We can transmit the torque or the turning moment and power from one component to another, which are apart from some distance. What is one component? One component is gear shaft. Another component is the rear axle. That means the propeller shaft will transmit the torque and power from gearbox shaft to the rear axle, which are apart at some distance, which are apart at some distance. And we were discussing about what is the material of propeller shaft. Generally, in common use, the common material for construction of high quality steel is used for propeller shaft. On specific applications, okay, where efficiency and speed are the primary importance, whereby the materials, the composite materials like epoxy composite, carbon fibers, glass fibers, thermoplastic polyimides with suitable resins are widely used, and these materials are used only on specific applications. Otherwise, the material used for propeller shaft is high quality steel. High quality steel. So this is, and as far as this working, how it works, as we know, you can see the figure. It consists of two universal joints, and you can see the propeller shaft. This propeller shaft, the propeller shaft connects the gear shaft to the rear axle. You can see it is shown clearly in the figure. The front engine rear wheel drive automobiles require propeller shaft to connect the transmission output shaft to the differential at the rear axle. What is rear axle? We are going to discuss hereafter. The propeller shaft transmits, rotary motion of transmission, output shaft to the differential, causing the rear wheels to rotate, At higher speeds of the vehicle, you can see, once when the engine is running at higher speeds, whirling of propeller shaft causes bending stresses in the material, which has to be reduced. At higher once when the vehicle is running on road at higher shaft. Okay, whirling of propeller shaft causes bending stresses. Bending stresses in the material, which has to be reduced. Otherwise, if the bending forces are more, the ultimately fracture of the propeller shaft or breaking of the propeller shaft will happen. Okay, it has to, whatever the propeller shaft it is there, it has to withstand the torsional loads coming on the propeller shaft once when the engine is running at higher speeds. Okay, the two parameters has to be reduced. One is once when the engine is running at higher speeds, the whatever the material which is selected for propeller shaft, it should withstand the torsional load which are coming on the propeller shaft. Another parameter which has to be reduced or which has to be controlled is whenever the vehicle is running at higher speeds, whenever the engine is running at higher speeds, whirling of propeller shaft causes the bending stresses in the material of the propeller shaft. How to reduce this? To reduce this, you can see the figure. The propeller shaft should be made tubular. You can see the shape of propeller shaft is tubular in nature. Tubular in nature. Okay. To reduce the bending stresses, propeller shaft should be made of tubular shape. And should be perfectly balanced, and it has to be perfectly balanced. Okay, apart from this, one or two universal joints, one or two universal joints are used to permit variations in the angle of drive. You can see on the gear side, on the rear axle side, one universal joint. It is, you can find, that means on gear shaft one universal joint, on the rear axle one universal joint. Okay, what this universal joint will do? This universal joint will prevent, okay, this universal joint will permit variations in the angle of drive. Variations in the angle of drive. Okay, variations in the angle of the engine and the transmissions are rigidly attached to the frame of the vehicle. The engine and the transmission are rigidly attached to the frame of the vehicle, while a rear axle housing is housed with wheels and differentially attached to the frame by springs. The springs compress or expand due to road irregularities, which changes angle of drive between the propeller shaft and the transmission shafts. Okay, this phenomena also changes distance between transmission and the differential. Which phenomena? Okay, whatever the springs which are used will compress or expand due to road irregularities, which changes the angle of drive between the propeller and transmission shafts. Okay, the universal joint accounts for variation in the angle of drive. The main function in this propeller shaft, which connects two different shafts, the universal joint, what it does, it permits the variation in the angle of drive. Okay, the figure clearly shows, okay, two universal joints are used, one on the gear shaft side, another on the rear axle side. Okay, this is how it is going to be in process. And this is how it is going to operate. And main function of this, once again I will repeat, the main function of this propeller shaft is it transmits the torque and power from main shaft to the rear axle of the vehicle, to the rear axle of the vehicle. And the materials which is used is high quality steel or propeller shaft. Okay, so these are the things, and the tubular shape for propeller shaft is provided to minimize the torsional effect and the bending stresses effect on the propeller shaft material once when the vehicle is running at higher speeds. Okay, fine. Now we should discuss another important component which we have seen in the previous figure of propeller shaft, that is universal joint. That is universal joint. What is this universal joint? What it does? Okay, how it influences for smooth operation of engine and the vehicle. Okay, universal joints, it plays a very predominant role as far as the propeller shaft and its operation is concerned, and as a for the automobile and the engine operation is concerned. Okay, what is this universal joint? What is its main function? How it influences for the smooth operation in minimizing the wear during the vehicle is running on the road. Okay, the question is, what is this universal joint? Universal joint, yes, it is a mechanical device. Universal joint is a mechanical device, allows one or more rotating shafts to be linked together. What are the two rotating members? In the previous figure we seen, one is the gear shaft, another one is the rear axle. Okay, universal joint is a mechanical device that allows one or more rotating shafts to be linked together, allowing the transmission of torque or rotary motion between the two rotating members. Universal joint also allows for transmission of power. Universal joint is also allows for transmission of power between two points that are not in line with each other. That are not in line with each other. Yes. Now we will know, we'll understand what is mechanical. Universal joint, yes, it is a mechanical device. It allows one or more rotating shafts to be linked together, allowing the transmission of torque or rotary motion between the two rotating members. Universal joints also allows for transmission of power between two points that are not in line with each other. Okay, or even we can say universal joint is a coupling. Universal joint, it is a coupling which connects rigid rods which are the axis of two points are inclined to each other. That means they are not in the same line. And it is commonly used in shafts that transmit rotary motion. Which are the shafts having rotary motion? One is crankshaft, one is gear shaft, one is rear axle shaft and propeller shaft. Okay. Universal joint, it is a positive device and it is a mechanical connection between rotating shafts which are not in line, which are not in parallel line, but intersecting each other. And universal joints are used to transmit motion, power, or both between the two rotating motors. The simplest, you can see where this, these, what is this, universal joints are applied. Typical applications of universal joints include, we can find its applications in aircraft, appliances, automobiles, mechanisms, and other parameters. Okay, now, if you see the figure, you can see the figure. Okay. Universal joint, it is known as a solid. You can see this first figure. This is the actual figure of universal joint. This one. And this is the, you can see. Universal joint, you can see it is a solid drive line. Would be, it is a bent, would be bent and finally broken at the angle of drive changes. Here you can see. Okay. Universal joint, it is a solid drive which is bent and finally broken at the angle of drive changes. It is a flexible joint called universal joint, which is used to move the drive or the propeller shaft without breaking. The universal joint transmits the torque even though the rear axle is moving up and down. This point is very important, okay? Universal joint, it is a flexible joint, okay? Which is used to move the drive line or the propeller shaft without breaking. The universal joint transmits the torque even though the rear axle is moving up and down. Rear axle will not have the rotationary, it will move up and down. Universal joints, you can see, are used as flexible connection. Okay, you see, you can see this is one universal joint and this is another universal joint. Okay, universal joints are used as flexible connection between two rigid shafts at an angle with each other. Okay, universal joints are used as flexible connection between two rigid shafts at an angle with each other. These joints allow the angular, you can see here, you can see the in the figure. Universal joints allow the angular movement between two shafts. Universal joint, it is a flexible connection, and universal joints allow the angular, you can see the figure, the angular movement between two shafts. I transmit power at an angle. First thing, let us understand universal joints. It is connected between two rotating components which are not in line, which are not in parallel. Okay. And another point, it is a flexible joint which connects between two rigid shafts. It connects between two rigid shafts. Okay. And universal joints transmits power and the torque between two shafts at an angle. Because it connects the two rigid shafts which are in angle, which are not in line, which are not in parallel. Okay. Now, as far as this, what happens if the universal joints are not there between the two rigid shafts, like for example, between gear shaft and the rear axle, and these two shafts are connected by propeller shaft, and this universal joint, it is a flexible joint. If the universal joints are not there, what happens? If the universal joint, it is not there, what happens is the power transmission will be difficult and there is a lot of power loss will be there between two shafts. Okay, and to avoid this, it is a flexible joint. It connects between two rigid shafts which are not in line, and these joints allow and permits the transmission of torque, transmission of power with an angle, by making an angle. So this is what about the universal joint. Then what are the advantages of having this universal joint? Okay. And the universal joint, the driven shaft does not remain constant. The speed of driven shaft will not be constant. Depending on the shaft inclination, the driven shaft speed fluctuates. Okay, if the angle is zero, the magnitude increases. When the angle is large, to achieve uniform shaft speed, to achieve uniform driven shaft speed, two universal joints has to be used at the end of propeller shaft. Generally, for common application, we are going to use, here you can see, this is, I will show here figure, this is one universal joint, this is another universal joint. Okay, so to minimize the fluctuations, to minimize the variations, to minimize the fluctuations in the speed of the driven shaft, two universal joints has to be used at the end of each propeller shaft. Now, what are the advantages of this universal joint? What are the advantages of this universal joint? What happens if it is not there? If the universal joint is absent, then one point already we know, there is a lots of loss between the power which is transmitted between one shaft to another shaft. Universal shaft minimizes the fluctuations in the speed of driven shaft. Okay, now, universal couplings are, as it is already told, universal joint, it is a coupling, and it is a flexible joint. Okay, and universal joint, it facilitates universal, another very, very important of having universal joint in the transmission system, that too at the end of propeller shaft, universal joint facilitates the torque transmission, between shafts, which have angular misalignment, And universal joints are cheap as far as the cost is concerned, and it is cost effective. And universal joint, it is simple to be assembled and dismantled whenever it is required. And by providing the universal joint at the end of propeller shaft, see, the transmission, torque transmission efficiency is high. Okay, there is minimal power loss between the two shafts while power is transmitted, and torque transmission efficiency is very high, Okay, this is, then what are the disadvantages of this universal joint? If you look into disadvantage, wear may occur if the joint is not properly lubricated. See, once when the two solid components are coming in direct contact, when the vehicle is running, that means always there is a possibility of wear. Okay. How the wear can be reduced? By providing lubrication. That too, in this case, the effective lubrication is very much appreciated to minimize the wear which is expected once when the vehicle is running at higher speeds, once when the torque transmitted from two shafts is more. During this situation, wear is more. To minimize the wear, effective lubrication should be provided. And maintenance is very frequently necessary to avoid the wear. Maintenance is very much appreciated to minimize the wear. And universal joint produces the fluctuating motion. I was telling, see, fluctuation in the speed of the driven shaft, it is minimized by providing universal joint. And still, the fluctuation can be very, very low by providing two universal joints at the end of the propeller shaft. Okay. And the another major drawback associated with universal joint is it universal joint will not support axial misalignment in the transmission system. Universal joint will not support axial misalignment. Which are the advantage and disadvantage which are associated as far as this universal joint is concerned. Now I hope you understood. Universal joint, in brief, I will tell you. It is a flexible coupling. It connects two rigid shafts which are not in line, okay, which are not in parallel. And this universal joint facilitates the transmission of power if the two rigid shafts are in angle. Okay. It minimizes the power losses during power transmission between the two shafts, and the torque efficiency will be more by providing the universal joint. This is all about the brief about as far as the universal joint is concerned. In general, the universal joints are made up of special grade steel alloy. Now, another important parameter which we have to discuss here, the rear axle. We were seeing the propeller shaft. The propeller shaft, this is a mechanical device which connects the main transmission shaft to the rear axle. Then what is rear axle? This rear axle is called back axle also. Then this, what is rear axle? And what the rear axle will do? Okay. What this rear axle will do? This we have to discuss here. And what is this rear axle? How it influence on smooth operation of the vehicle as well as the engine. Okay. Rear axle is that component of an automobile on which the two rear wheels are mounted. I was telling in the previous section while we were discussing about the propeller shaft. Okay. Rear axle is that component of an automobile on which the two rear wheels are mounted. In case of a rear wheel drive vehicle, a rear axle, it also allows differential casing together with differential in it to be mounted on it. Okay. Then the propeller shaft, it takes the drive from transmission and transmits it to the differential, from where the power goes to the driving wheels through the rear axle. So here you can see in the figure. So this is the rear axle. Just you concentrate the figure. Rear axle casing you can find. And these are the two rear wheels. This is one wheel and this is another wheel. This is the rear axle. Okay. This rear axle, the propeller shaft takes the drive from transmission and transmits it to the differential, from where the power goes to the driving wheel to the rear axle. Okay. A dead axle is one which carries a part of the vehicle weight. Here in rear axle, two axles will be there. One is dead axle, another one is a live axle. dead axle will take the weight of the vehicle, but it does not drive the wheels connected to it. And another component which is mounted on it, the live axle, it carries the vehicle weight and also drives the wheel connected to it. Okay, that axle, it will not drive the vehicle, but it takes the weight of the vehicle. Whereas live axle, you can find here in the filler, in the figure, the live axle carries vehicle weight and also drives the wheels connected to it, and also drives the wheel connected to it. Then we should, now we know what is this rear axle. Rear axle, it is the axle which takes the weight of the vehicle, and it also drives the vehicle, and it facilitates two wheels to be mounted on this axle. Here two axles will be there. Dead axle will carry only the weight of the vehicle, but it will not drive the wheels connected to it. The live axle carries the vehicle weight and also drives the wheels connected to it. Now we described what is rear axle. Now we should see what this rear axle will perform. What is its function? The rear axle, it acts as a beam. It acts, you can see that, it acts as a beam upon the ends of which the rod wheels can revolve, and through which the weight of the body and load can be transmitted via the springs and the rod wheels to the top. Okay, so the main function of this rear axle is, it acts as a beam upon the ends of which the rod wheels can revolve, and through which the weight of the body and load can be transmitted via, you can see the springs, via the springs and the rod wheels to the ground. And this rear axle will also act as a housing to support the final drive. This is the main important function of this rear axle. The rear axle will act as a housing to support the final drive. The differential and the shaft that transmit the drive to the rod wheel. The main function of this rear axle is, it acts as a housing to support the final drive. The differential and the shafts that transmit the drive to the rod wheels. That transmit the drive to the rod wheels. Okay, this is how the, and this as far as the material is concerned, the rear axle, this material is made up of cast iron. Okay, you can see the figure, it is a simple figure, it is a light diagram. You can see all the components. You can see the pinion shaft is supported in the bearing in the axle casing, and the, it takes the drive from the propeller shaft. From the propeller shaft. Okay, what is this propeller shaft? Already we have seen propeller shaft, it connects the gear shaft to the rear axle. Okay, so there are different types of rear axles are there. One is these rear axles will take up the weight of the body and will minimize the torque reactions and the driving thrust, the sideway forces. All these parameters has to be withstand whatever the material which is used for this rear axle. Okay. Now we should see another important component. This is Hotchkiss drive. What is this Hotchkiss drive? Okay, this Hotchkiss drive, it is a shaft drive, and it is a device which is incorporated in the power transmission system. Okay, and the name, why this has come as a Hotchkiss, in fact, It is manufactured initially by a Hotchkiss Private Limited of Germany. Okay. Hotchkiss drive, it combines the springing and positioning or locating of, I will show the figure. Okay. This Hotchkiss drive, it combines the springing and positioning or locating of the rear axle. It uses a rigid axle with leaf spring mounted at its extremities as far apart as possible on the rear axle. And this, you can see the figure. The Hotchkiss drive, it consists of a leaf spring. The Hotchkiss drive, so this is it. I can show you the cursor. Yes. The Hotchkiss drive consists of a leaf spring and a propeller shaft with two universal joints and one sliding joint. And as far as this is concerned, in this arrangement, the springs decide taking the weight of the body. See, what are the springs? I will show you. The springs, besides taking the weight of the body, also take the torque reaction, driving thrust, and side forces. And Hotchkiss drive, it consists of an open propeller shaft. You can see the propeller shaft. It consists of an, I'll bring this here. This is the propeller shaft. The Hotchkiss drive, it consists of an open propeller shaft secured to the transmission output shaft and differential pin gear shaft. The propeller shaft is also, you can see in the figure, the propeller shaft is provided with two universal joints and a sliding joint as shown in the figure. The springs are bolted to the axle casing. The front end of the spring is rigidly fixed to the frame while the rear end is connected to the frame by swings. Okay, then as far as this Hotchkiss is concerned, it supports the smooth operation of the vehicle by minimizing the torque reactions or variations in the torque. Okay, so this is how the torque Hotchkiss drive, it consists of springs, it consists of a leaf spring. The shape of the spring is of leaf kind, and it carries the weight of the vehicle, and it also supports in absorbing the road wheel shocks. And this Hotchkiss material, generally it is made up of, okay, it is made up of cast iron material. Okay, it is made up, and the springs are made up of special high grade steel so that they can retain their strength at higher speeds of the flight.